The 50th anniversary Freedom Ride leaves Sydney University tomorrow. Back in 1965, a group of university students, led by Aboriginal rights campaigner Charlie Perkins, set out to throw the spotlight on racial segregation in the north and northwest of New South Wales.
A lot of Australians talk about, oh yes, we want to give the Aborigine a fair go, then it's full stop and it's usually forgotten. They never go on to say, look, we've proposed that we give such and such a scholarship to a number of Aborigines. Let us support Aboriginal organisation. Let us vote in favour of any legislation which allows for the elevation of the Aboriginal people. They don't do these things. They talk about it, but they never do it.
Good evening. This afternoon, a busload of university students leave Sydney for Walgett in the northwest of New South Wales. They plan on protesting there the segregation laws that affect Aborigines, both in Walgett and in other rural towns. They expect to arrive in Walgett tomorrow.
The Freedom Riders found endemic racism and segregation with mob barred from pubs, swimming pools and parks. Their challenge to this racism was a seminal moment in the history of Australian civil rights. Young law student Jim Spigelman was on the bus and went on to work for Prime Minister Gough Whitlam, became a judge and is now chairman of the ABC. I spoke to him earlier today and asked how bad the racism they found was.
We only had some indications of what might be there before we left. What we found was much more entrenched and detailed and widespread than anything we had heard about before we left. And that was the real impact of the, one of the real impacts of the Freedom Ride, was drawing the attention of the broader Australian community to just how significant and widespread at the degree of racial discrimination was in rural New South Wales.
And do you think the protest had that impact?
Oh yes, yes. People didn't know, for example. We didn't know before we left, and there was no knowledge in the broader community, particularly in the cities, that several local government councils had passed formal resolutions prohibiting Indigenous Australians from attending the municipal swimming pools. I don't think anyone knew that there was an RSL club, at least one that we demonstrated outside, that refused to allow ex-servicemen who were Indigenous to become members of the RSL club and use its facilities. I mean, these were men and women who fought for Australia, but they weren't allowed to join the RSL in these particular town. These things were not known. They became known as a result of the Freedom Ride.
What was the reaction of the Aboriginal people that you met along the way? Were you resented or in fact applauded?
Well, it varied. There were some people who were fearful of these city kids blowing into town, causing mayhem and then leaving. But there are others who felt energised by the experience, said so at the time and acted accordingly. We were very conscious of the problem of just blowing into town. So we had determined that we would return to those towns, and we did. I mean, in smaller groups, not in one big bus, but in smaller groups. There were return visits in the year or two afterwards. But there was quite significant support that we received instantaneously from in some communities. I wouldn't say it was everywhere, but it definitely in some communities.
On the 50th anniversary of the Freedom Rides, do you think Australians know enough about this important chapter in our history?
There are lots of parts of our history that we need to know more about. This was of some significance. I wouldn't exaggerate its significance. I think we played a role in the success of the 1967 referendum only because of the publicity that we received and that was given to the extent of discrimination. And that was a much more important turning point, if you like, because it led to real reform. We had an impact in some of those towns. It wasn't always immediate, and immediately it wasn't always good. But I think in the long run, yes, it was a positive impact.